Hey guys, our next tree is Quercus alba, our white oak. Quercus alba, the scientific name Quercus, actually is the same genus that we'll be using for all of our oak trees. Alba, the specific epithet of that scientific name, means white, so it's literally white oak in scientific Latin. This tree is the one we're actually going to be comparing a lot of our other oaks to over the course of the semester, so it's a good one to learn early on. Out in the woods, what you're going to look for when you see this tree is a very tall, pale bark tree, so usually pale gray to gray. At the base, you'll see that it has these blocky pieces of the bark kind of scaled up against the tree, and they're very tight and oppressed. But as you travel up the tree and you look higher up into the branches and the upper regions, you'll see that the bark gets more platy and kind of peely off of those branches. And that's going to help distinguish it from some of the other oaks that we're going to learn later in the semester. The next thing you're going to want to look for after you see that bark and you're starting to get that, oh, I think this might be an oak, I think this could be a white oak, you're going to want to start looking for leaves. Maybe you see them on the ground, maybe you look up high into the tops of the trees and you're looking for the shape of that leaf. You're going to see that these leaves are simple and pinnately veined. Pinnately veined meaning feather-like, and so you have that middle piece and then the veins shooting off either end. So looking closer at this leaf, we can see that it has many lobes all the way along it. And all the lobes are smooth. They don't have any toothing, and they don't have any bristle tips on the ends. You'll only see bristle tips on the leaves of red oak trees. So if you don't see any bristle tips and you're sure it's an oak tree, you know you're in the white oak group. So looking at this leaf, you're gonna see that it's kind of like a greenish color. This is actually pretty dark. I think it's leftover from a previous year, but you can see that you've got the paler on the underside. Often white oaks, you'll see them when they're flashing in the wind. You'll have that pale underside and that bright green top. It's important to understand with oak trees that their leaves can be variable. So these leaves can be much larger than they are, and the lobes might not be quite as pronounced on some leaves than other leaves. And some, they might be even more dissected, depending on whether they are sun leaves or shade leaves. Another thing about oak trees that you're gonna wanna pay attention to is if you look on the twig, getting pretty close, you're gonna see those buds kind of clustered. That means that there's many of them right in this one area. That's typical of all the oak tree species. Some people can actually identify oaks from looking at their buds. We won't be going that intense this semester. The next thing you're gonna look at, let me see if I can find my acorns. Oh, they're in my pocket. So acorns haven't quite dropped yet for this year, but we have some new ones, these little babies, that haven't quite fully ripened. You can see he's still green. As he matures over the course of the fall up on these trees, they're going to get a nice dark brown color. But what I want you to look at is the cap. So looking at the cap, you can see it's very warty. You've got little bumps all the way along, and this is a very typical for a white oak cap. So we're looking at the cap versus the actual nut. Here's some older ones from that are fully mature. The nuts have been all eaten because they're super tasty for wildlife. That's actually one of the important things you should know about white oak, is that it's one of the most important plants for wildlife in the southeastern woodlands. Animals love white oak acorns. They are delicious. They have very few tannins compared to other oak trees. Tannins are things like what you find in coffee or tea or red wine that give it that bitter taste, and animals don't like bitter taste any more than we do. And so white oaks are very low in that tannins in their nuts, and so those are the first acorns that all the animals are going to go after in the fall. They actually germinate their acorns in the fall, and this is because they're so tasty. They need to germinate as quickly as possible. As they fall off the tree, they're going to wait for a second and then they're going to start germinating, because the sooner they can germinate and put down their roots and turn into a little baby tree, the less likely they are to be eaten by a squirrel or a chipmunk or someone else, like a deer. Red oaks, on the other hand, are actually going to mature later in the spring. They'll start germinating then, and that's because they can afford to hang out, because they invested in putting tannins into those acorns. They're less delicious for other species. You also need to know about the wood value of this tree. So white oaks are very valuable for wood as well. You'll see it in cabinets, you'll see it in furniture, you'll see it in planks and floorboards and buildings. And even beer barrels. So one of the cool things about the white oak group is that they have watertight wood, so it's not going to leak all the way through. Red oaks don't have that, so you have to have a white oak tree in order to make those beer barrels. And that's all I've got for you guys. So this is Quercus alba, our white oak. Stay tuned for the next tree.